How did we stand, Mr. President, even if we have to stand 6 feet apart for a few weeks? And divided, we fall.
Well, it is a working weekend for the U.S. Senate. Lawmakers trying to hammer out a coronavirus stimulus package. As Republicans and Democrats have been meeting to discuss the terms of the deal, get into those details to help us, we're told, that it could exceed one or maybe even $2 trillion. So how will what they are doing now, working on it at this moment, how will that prop up the economy? And what else can the government do to protect us? Texas Senator John Cornyn is with us. He's a member of the Senate Finance and Judiciary Committee. Senator, welcome. You know,
thank you.
Good to see you. A lot of people worried about lost income. Many have nothing coming in. They don't know how long this will last. What would you like to see in the financial package, and how can it help?
Well, we know the first thing we need to do is stop the virus, and that's what we're all doing by exercising good personal hygiene, maintaining social distancing and the like. If you're sick, to see your doctor so you can get tested to see whether you need to be monitored at home or need to go into the hospital. But you're right, people are being denied access to a paycheck through no fault of their own. They work for a restaurant in the hospitality industry or any one of a number of businesses. When government tells you don't go to work, you can't earn a paycheck, we got to do something to fill the gap. So one of the most important things that this bill will do is provide money to people who are out of work and not receiving a paycheck. Some through a direct payment, and we're trying to figure out how to get that to them as fast as possible to tide them over. And for those who can file then for unemployment insurance, how do we beef up that unemployment insurance system so that people can provide for themselves and their families during the interim?
You know, according to some of the what's being considered, it'd be a payment of $1,200 to individuals. Married couples would get $2,400, $500 for each child, but the your individual income has to be below $75,000. Married couples, $150,000. You said to get it to us. I mean, the IRS has got us on their list. Can they direct deposit? Would this be checks? Would it come through employers? How have they worked that out yet?
Well, they haven't worked out the details, but it's going to go through the IRS because they, as you say, they've got everybody's number and Social Security number, taxpayer identification number, and know how to get the money to us quickly. And that's why that part's important. But as you can tell, even though that's a significant amount of money, it's not enough on a week after week basis for people who are out of work. This is really just a way to throw them a lifeline. Until we can find out how to maintain either through unemployment insurance or to keep businesses to encourage their employees to stay on the payroll, even though they may not have the demand coming in the front door until we ride this thing out. We don't know whether that's going to be a matter of weeks or months.
And do you know, government's supposed to protect us. What's your sense of actually what went wrong? I mean, with all the reports of lack of ventilators, masks, we're the greatest country on earth with the most sophisticated medical system, yet we've been caught short by this. Do you think we've learned from this? Do you think it will be solved? What made us go off the rails?
Well, I think there are a lot of lessons to be learned from this. This came out of nowhere. But if we had thought about it, SARS, another type of respiratory virus, came out of China as a result of the practice of eating, of having these wild animal markets, and they jumped from animals to human beings. So we need to look at China in a whole different way in terms of these viruses, obviously trying to protect us, but also because they are our supply chain for medication and medical equipment and the like. But on the back end, you're right. For those who are desperately ill, and fortunately, it'll just be a very small fraction of those infected, mainly elderly people and those with underlying illnesses. The respirators, we need this. We need that supply available and usable in a time of crisis like this. But this is really unprecedented. So it's hard to know how we could have prepared for all of this. Usually what happens is when a crisis happens, everybody wants to act. Once the crisis passes, then it's real hard to maintain the same sort of momentum to deal with it, the eventuality should it occur again. But we got to learn from this, and we will.
Well, certainly we had the warnings. Hopefully, as you said, we will learn from this. And as you said, it is a war against, just like practically like World War II, against this virus. Senator John Cornyn of Texas, thank you, and stay safe, and to all your constituents, too.
Thanks, Eric.
Of course.